One of my favorite vegetables to paint is eggplant. I love its shape, its texture, and sometimes they come in really cool colors. But when I'm cooking with eggplant, my favorite thing to make right now is this authentic Greek moussaka with eggplant. And even though you're probably gonna wanna go on vacation after you make this, it's gonna be worth it. We're gonna start off with two large eggplants, and you wanna take the tops and bottoms off each one. I'm going to be making enough for about 8 to 10 people, but you can easily cut this recipe in half if you want to. I'm going to peel the eggplants by taking off one strip of skin, making a quarter turn, and then taking off another strip. Some recipes say to peel the eggplants, others say not to, so I figure this is kind of a good compromise. Now I'm going to take each one and slice it lengthwise, about half an inch thick. You could also slice it horizontally into rounds, but I find these pieces a little easier to work with. Now I'm going to take a teaspoon of salt and evenly distribute it among all this eggplant. You can use more salt if you need to, just make sure every piece gets some because we want to draw out the liquid. Take your eggplant slices and place them upright in a colander, that way the water can drip out of the bottom. And now you want to set this into the sink or in a bowl to catch the liquid, and let it sit for 30 minutes, and this is what it's going to look like. You're going to notice that the water is starting to come out of them. If they change color a little bit, don't be alarmed. I usually take about 3 slices at a time, and I try to wring more liquid out of them. And now it's really important to wash off all that salt, so just run it under the tap and then give it a couple of gentle rings to get out the excess water. So do that to all the rest of your eggplant slices, and when that's done, you'll want to heat up a skillet with a good amount of oil. We're going to get ready to fry these. Now if you wanted to do this step the day before, by all means do so, it'll save yourself a lot of time. My heat's on medium high, and I'm just gonna fry these up in batches until they're a nice golden brown. Unlike that one right there, which probably could have used another minute. But once they're ready, you wanna transfer them onto a plate, and just keep frying up your eggplant slices the same way until they're all nice and golden brown. Now for the meat sauce, I'm gonna use the same skillet. I'm just gonna wipe out that last little bit of eggplant because I'm oh so lazy today. In there goes a little oil, 2 diced onions, and 4 cloves of minced garlic. I did those up in the food processor to save me a little bit of time. Saute this on medium high for about 30 seconds and then add a couple of inches of cinnamon stick and 3 whole cloves. Now I'm gonna stir this around for another 30 seconds and then add in 1 pound of ground beef and 1/2 pound of ground pork. I'm a big fan of season as you go, so I'm gonna add some salt and pepper. Now if you wanted to make this totally authentic, you would use ground lamb, but in any event, you wanna brown your meat until all the pink is gone. And then I'm gonna add in some dried oregano, a couple of sprigs of thyme. And if I had a bay leaf right now, I'd add one of those in too, but I don't have any. Now here comes 1 cup of tomato puree and 2 tablespoons of tomato paste. This isn't going to be a very saucy meat sauce like you would use for lasagna or spaghetti. This one's a little bit more firm. I'm gonna add about 1/2 cup of water to loosen it up a bit because now we have to bring it to a boil and then simmer it for about 10 minutes or until it's thickened and really flavorful. After 10 minutes, I'm gonna add some fresh parsley. And you want to check it for seasoning at this point, just make sure there's enough salt and pepper. Take out the cinnamon stick and the thyme sprigs, and you didn't think I was going to forget about those cloves. This part is kind of a pain, I know, so if you wanted to skip the whole cloves and instead use about 1/8 teaspoon of ground cloves, that'll work too. Good grief. Transfer your meat sauce into a bowl to cool completely, and now we're going to prep our potatoes. I have here 3 russet potatoes that I'm gonna cover with cold water. Each one of those is about 200 grams. I'm gonna take these to the stove and add a little bit of salt. And I'm gonna bring these to a boil and let them cook for about 10 to 12 minutes. If your potatoes are smaller, you might wanna cook them for less than that. You don't wanna cook them all the way, and you definitely don't want them to be mushy. But peel them when they come out of the water and they're cool enough to handle, and you should be able to slice them without them falling apart. If we didn't do this step, then our potatoes would be a little bit too hard, but this is what they should look like when you slice them. They're still quite firm and they don't fall apart one little bit. Alright, now we have to make our bechamel sauce. So into a pot over medium heat, I'm going to add 1/3 cup of butter, and I'm just going to swirl it around a little bit and then stir in 3/4 cup of flour. So just cook this until all the traces of dry flour have disappeared. And now you want to slowly add in 3 cups of whole milk. You want to add it about half a cup at a time. If you add it in all at once, then your sauce could be really lumpy. So you just add it bit by bit and whisk the entire time. You can't whisk too much here, guys. Eventually, you can add more and more milk. And you want to cook this for a few minutes until you can start to feel it thicken. You're going to notice it when you're whisking, that it'll almost resemble kind of like a pudding. As soon as it starts boiling over medium heat, you want to cook it for about 3 to 4 minutes. And continuing to whisk certainly doesn't hurt. Now we're going to get our egg yolks ready. So separate 3 eggs, but I want you to save those whites too, because we are going to be using those later on. Now I'm going to take a few glugs of that hot bechamel and add them to my egg yolks to increase the temperature. This is called tempering, and the reason you do that is because if I were to dump those egg yolks right into the hot sauce, it would shock them and we'd end up with scrambled eggs. So it's an important step. It just brings up their temperature. This way we can end up with a really smooth sauce. So whisk that in really well. And now we're going to season this with some salt, some white pepper, and a few grates of fresh nutmeg. If you're using nutmeg that's already ground, I would say a very conservative pinch will be enough. Now we're gonna stir in about half a cup of Parmesan cheese. You could certainly add more if you wanted to. And there we have our bechamel all ready to go. Now my meat sauce has had a chance to cool completely. I'm gonna take those egg whites and whisk them by hand for about 8 to 10 minutes until firm peaks form. You could certainly use an electric mixer to do that, but I just felt like doing it by hand. I'm gonna stir in 2 tablespoons of breadcrumbs into my meat mixture, and then I'm gonna fold in my egg whites. This is gonna give our meat sauce a little bit more body, and it's gonna help it hold its shape. All right, now everything's ready, and we can finally assemble our moussaka. So I'm just gonna take that same skillet, I didn't even wash it after making the meat sauce, and I'm gonna layer all the potatoes on the bottom. If you're using a casserole dish for this, do be sure that you grease it. But I'm gonna lay all my potatoes down on the bottom, even if I have to overlap them. And now I'm gonna take half of my eggplant slices and put a layer of those on top of the potatoes. Just fit them together so it's kind of like a puzzle. You wanna use half of it. And now we're gonna take all of our meat sauce and dump the whole entire thing over this eggplant. I know a lot of recipes call for multiple layers, and you could certainly do that. But I'm just gonna spread all of the meat sauce in one layer, and on top of that I'm gonna sprinkle some Parmesan cheese. And now I'm gonna take the second half of my eggplant slices and fit those together like a puzzle. Once those are all in place, you can just press it down a little bit firmly, and now we can take our beautiful bechamel sauce and pour all of that over top. And some of you might be thinking that my skillet's way too full and that sauce is gonna overflow, but not to worry guys, bechamel really doesn't expand when it bakes. So spread that all around, and I'm gonna sprinkle about another 1/2 cup to 1 cup of Parmesan cheese on top. And now I'm gonna bake this in a preheated 350°F or 176°C oven for about 1 hour, or until the bechamel is nice and golden around the edges, just like this. Now you can sprinkle a little fresh parsley on top, and you have to let this rest for about 15 to 20 minutes before you cut into it, guys. And if you're a regular viewer of this channel, then you're probably tired of hearing me say that. But there we have our lovely, authentic Greek moussaka all ready to serve up. This would make any yaya super proud. We're gonna dig into that golden creamy bechamel and that beautiful spicy meat filling. Yeah, it was a mountain load of work, but I tell you guys, it'll be totally worth it.